According to the Bohm, the apparent faster-than-light connection between subatomic particle is really telling us that there is a deeper level of reality, as we are not privy to a more complex dimension beyond our own that is analogous to the aquarium. And he adds, we view objects such as subatomic particles as separate from one another because we are seeing only a portion of their reality. Such particles are not separate parts, but facets of a deeper and more underlying unity that is ultimately as holographic and indivisibly as the previously mentioned rose. And since everything in the physical reality is comprised of these eidolons, the universe is itself a projection, a hologram. In addition to its phantom-like nature, such a universe would possess other rather startling features. If the apparent separateness of subatomic particle is illusionary, it means that at a deeper level of reality, all things in the universe are infinitely interconnected. The electrons in a carbon atom in the human brain are connected to the subatomic particle that comprises every salmon that swims, every heart that beats, and every star that shimmers in the sky. Everything penetrates everything, and although human nature may seek to categorize and pigeonhole and subdivide the various phenomena of the universe, all are of necessity artificial, and all of nature is ultimately a seamless web. Now, super hologram. In a holographic universe, even time and space could no longer be viewed as fundamentals, because concepts such as location break down in a universe in which nothing is truly separate from anything else. Time and three-dimensional space, like the images of the fish on the TV monitor, could also have to be viewed as projection of this deeper order. At its deeper level, reality is a sort of super hologram in which the past, present, and the future all exist simultaneously. This suggests that, given the proper tools, it might even be possible to someday reach into the super holographic level of reality and pluck out scenes from the long forgotten past. But that all what else the super hologram contains is an open-ended question. Allowing for the sake of argument that the super hologram is a matrix that has given birth to everything in our universe, at the very least it contains every subatomic particle that has been or will be, or every configuration of matter and energy that is possible, from snowflakes to quasars, from blue whales to gamma rays. It must be seen as a sort of cosmic storehouse of all that is. Although Bohm concedes that we have no way of knowing what else might lie hidden in the super hologram, he does venture to say that we have no reason to assume it does not contain more. Or as he puts it, perhaps the super holographic level of reality is a mere stage beyond which lies an infinity of further development. Bohm is not the only researcher who found evidence that the universe is a hologram. Working independently in the field of brain research, Stanford neurophysiologist Karl Pribram has also become persuaded of the holographic nature of reality. Pribram was drawn to the holographic model by the puzzle of how and where memories are stored in the brain. For decades, numerous studies have shown that rather than being confined to a specific location, memories are dispersed throughout the brain. In the 1960s, Pribram encountered the concept of holography and realized he has found the explanation brain scientist has been looking for. Pribram believed memories are encoded not in neurons or small groupings of neurons, but in patterns of nerves, impulses that crisscrosses the entire brain in the same way that patterns of laser light interference crisscrosses the entire area of a piece of film containing a holographic image. is. In other words, Pribram believes that the brain itself is a hologram. Pribram theory also explains how the human brain can store so many memories in so little space. It has been estimated that a human brain has the capacity to memorize something of the order of 10 billion bits of information during the average human lifetime. The brain is an electrochemical machine that stores information, binary code. One of the most amazing things about the human thinking process is that every piece of information seems instantly crossed, correlated with every other piece of information. Another information seems instantly cross-correlated with every other piece of information. Another feature instinctive to the hologram. Because every portion of a hologram is infinitely interconnected with every other portion, it is perhaps nature's supreme example of cross-correlated system. The storage of memory is not the only neurophysical puzzle that becomes more tractable in light of Pribram's holographic model of the brain. Another is how the brain is able to translate the avalanche of frequencies it receives via the senses, light frequencies, sound frequencies, and so on. Into the concrete world of our perceptions. Encoding and decoding frequencies is precisely what a hologram does best. Just as the hologram functions as a sort of lens, a translating device able to convert an apparently meaningless blur of frequencies into a coherent image. Pribram believes that the brain also comprises a lens and uses holographic principles to mathematically convert the frequencies it receives through the senses into the inner world of our perceptions. An impressive body of evidence suggests that the brain uses holographic principle to perform its operation. Pribram's theory, in fact, has gained increasing support among neurophysiologists.